So, welcome! Let's do something musical again. As you might know, Cork Gadget on the iPad is one of my favorite ways to make music. It's one of my favorite DAWs. I even use it to do some basic mixing. However, it has its limitations. It's a great music creation and sketching tool, but its mixing facilities are kind of limited. It's especially limited in the audio department. You cannot really work with audio tracks other than samples. This is where another DAW comes into play, and that's Steinberg's Cubasis. Suppose you want to add some vocals or some guitars or some acoustic instruments to your Gadget project. Well, that's something that Cubasis is really good at. It's really good at working with audio. Also, it supports audio unit plugins, such as FabFilter Pro Q3. That's really great because you can run multiple instances of that plugin. In this video, I'm going to use Cubasis a little bit for mixing. Just a word in advance, I'm kind of a hobbyist and a novice when it comes to mixing and audio engineering, so take it with a grain of salt. But yeah, I think it's just a nice way to just kind of enhance your Gadget creations a bit, add maybe a little bit more production value to it, and well, I hope you can learn something from it and do something with it for your own projects. So let's get to it. So, here is my latest Gadget project. It's called Northern Note, and I just created it. And well, yeah, it's got about 10 tracks. I've just got a few basic things here. As you can see, you can have these inserts, but that's what I would normally use. But in this case, we're going a step further. Let's load up Cubasis. I've got the same project here. As you can see, this is audio tracks and not MIDI. And well, that's just one of the big differences between Gadget and Cubasis. Although Cubasis can do MIDI as well. But yeah, the beauty of Gadget is that it has its own built-in instruments. Whereas in Cubasis you would need to use external ones, and there's a lot of apps that do not really use audio unit capability yet, especially those from Cork. So that's why Gadget is great for the creation and Cubasis is great for the mixing. So that's what we're going to do. Let's get to it. Right, I hope the camera is in focus, because in my previous take it wasn't in focus. I'm going to do a little bit of demonstration of how you can use Cork Gadget in conjunction with Cubasis for things like mixing and finalizing a track. Normally I would create my music, my tracks with Cork Gadget, and then also mix it in Cork Gadget. But its mixing facilities are somewhat limited, and this is where Cubasis can be used. So here is my new project. It's called Northern Note. And this is what it sounds like. This is the intro section. And as you can see, normally you can have about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 insert effects per channel. But in this case, I'm not really using them except for maybe 1 or 2. For instance, on channel 8, I have a reverb effect set. And on channel 7, I have a compressor and a phaser and a reverb. So those things are fine for like sound design purposes. But of course, yeah, you can only do so much. For me personally, it's well, good enough. It's fairly simple and not too complicated. But yeah, if you want to go a little bit further, you can use Cubasis to help you out with that. So this is what my track is made of. We have 4 Cork WaveStation sounds. The first one is Skyjam. Then our second one is Soft Waves. I like how this has a very sort of bassy like texture. It's like the attack of a bass and then the smoothness of a string. This is Fire Dance, another well-known Korg Wave Station patch. And then we have Vox Concrete. Okay, that's our four wave station sounds. Now I have four different M1 sounds. The first one is Jet Bass. It's like a metallic sounding bass. And then Syn Bass 5. Then I have the very famous Universe patch. And then I have Wind Chimes, which is like an FM bell type of sound. And then I have a Bilbao sampler with some samples that I made from Fairlight CMI. I recorded those myself from the CMI app. But I'm not using that sound, I'm using this one, Jet Pass 1. And finally I have the fan cover sampler. And yeah, this one uses some eerie sounds. So that's basically my track. Now let's go to some random track in the song. This is scene number 6. Or this one. Added a few extra things to it. And then the intro. So that's all very nice and dandy, and I have exported this in Gadget using the iTunes option, and then the tracks get exported right here on my iPad, Korg Gadget, and the WAV files end up somewhere here. They are like there. And then we go to Cubasis. I now have imported all those audio tracks into Cubasis. As you can see, it sounds like this. Now apparently I only have one track playing. So, you can easily work on different tracks, as you can see, and now have track number 4, which is Korg Wave Station sound. This is also a classic Wave Station sound. Maybe I want to loop this a little bit, like so, and add an effect to it. What about a little bit of reverb perhaps? Oh, of course I have to set it to looping. So now it loops. Add just a touch of reverb. Like so. But maybe I want to work a little bit on the bass. And this bass, maybe I want to use an audio unit like FabFilter. Well, we can do that as well. And FabFilter, because it's an audio unit, allows multiple instances to be used. So let's choose an EQ that's kind of good for bass, perhaps. Ooh, it sounds different already. Completely changes the sound, and this is a very complex and advanced plugin. You can mess about with the sound quite a bit. Yeah, maybe I want a little bit more high in it. Maybe I want to boost this perhaps a little bit. So yeah, there's a lot you can do there. And of course we have here the mixer. We can easily like change the balance. Maybe I want to pan this one a little bit to the right and that one a little bit to the left. Oh, maybe not that one. Maybe I want this one centered. So now I should have two basses. Yeah, okay, I'm now working on track number 6. And track number 6 has a bass that is a little bit iffy. It's that Syn bass 5. And maybe I want to change the loop point to here. So that I have a little bit more of it. Maybe we can improve this bass a little bit. Anyway, you kind of get the idea of what I'm trying to achieve here. That's just one of the many things you can do. And yeah, you can have these effects on all your channels. You can go completely full out with this. Now I want to perhaps hear everything. So now I have everything here. Maybe I think that universe is a bit too loud. Well, I can just reduce the volume like so. Also, yeah, you can easily change the panning and well, do a lot of things with it. Yeah, so that kind of concludes my demonstration. I hope it kind of gives you an insight of the possibilities. I'm not really the best at dealing with FabFilter or that sort of plugins. I'm pretty much a novice on that field. But yeah, I think it's nice that you could just export your gadget tracks as WAV files and import them into Cubase and kind of bring it to the next level. So that was the end of the demonstration.
So that was it, a demonstration of using Cubase to enhance your Cork Gadget projects. Well, I hope you learned something from it and that it may give you some ideas to enhance your Gadget projects a bit. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.